Yeah.
Who do you guys think is gonna win RuPaul's Drag Race season 9?
I
don't either.
69, more like it.
I want Adora to win again, except for she didn't win the first time.
Can you guys scream?
I guess it's a spoiler.
Ooh, wrong thing selected, but I saw it early.
My hair does not look pink in this light at all. Weird.
Yeah, what a fake gamer girl you are.
So fucking fake.
I gotta stop doing that.
Huh?
I am going to dye my hair pink after PAX.
You should.
I'm gonna. I'm just gonna copy Jennifer on everything.
I'm gonna dye my asshole pink. A lot of the popular streamers are dyeing their asshole, like they're bleaching it, and I'm like, nah.
No, I'm gonna dye it darker.
Darker.
Dark brown, baby.
Is dye my asshole black.
Stomach loudly growling.
Oh, it's Nika's dog.
He's laying behind me.
Uh-oh.
He's sleeping. Whenever.
You know what that means.
Someone's going to complain.
Gonna get some emails.
Mamma mia.
Nika, why is your dog breathing? Why is he alive?
Because he's a good boy.
He's a very good boy. What if it is
like I was such a dumb idiot. Last night, Danny and I were sitting on the couch and we were watching TV, and I looked over at Axton, and his face is like in this weird, like, smushed position. But my heart filled with so much joy, and I loved him, and I realized that he is going to die, and I started crying so hard.
Well, Jennifer and I have had that issue because Addie got sick.
Addie got sick on Monday, and it was awful.
And I'm like, oh, she's
How
dead.
She doing
I was
now?
Like having a panic attack like all day on Monday at work. It sucked very Aww. Bad. She wasn't eating and was being super lethargic, and she threw up, and she like had an accident in her bed, which is super weird.
An accident back to back.
Yeah, she like peed like two times. It was so bad. It was so scary. And I talked to another lady in the building who has a dog, and her dog was sick too. So we think that like there's something weird like around outside. Well, there's also like an ass load of salt. And like the weird blue salt outside, so I'm like, maybe she like something. And, like...
and I keep on feeding her blue salt because I think it's funny. Well, and I'm a huge fan of Breaking Bad, so.
Well, I was like, I fed her a tortilla chip and two Honey Nut Cheerios. That's what
and
did it.
And I'm like, that's what did it.
That's it, Jennifer.
Two Honey Nut Cheerios.
That's what
spoiled
did it.
Spoiled her tongue with that.
This asshole die off of two Honey Nut Cheerios, but she's
Do
fine
you
now.
Guys want to see the not safe for work artwork? That I get because of Patreon now. What's everyone's thoughts?
Is it?
Yes. Whose is it?
I can't.
No, you're. Then you'll show it.
No, I can't.
Because then people.
I sent one of them to the. I need my footies. To our.
Was that?
Oh boy.
Whoa.
Robot Bachmann. Robo Bachmann.
Can't stop me. Robo Dicks.
Oh, that is the wrong mic.
Is that the robo dick talking
right now? Is it not the right one?
No.
That is 100% not, the right, not the right one.
It's not, I know why it's fucked. Hold up. It was just how
I sounded like a serial killer before.
It was terrifying.
It was so good.
I was hoping you would come back, Mike Bachmann, but you didn't.
It was really
I'm here.
Good.
I'm right here.
I know, but...
Do it again.
No, don't do it.
I can't anymore.
Nah. Jennifer... I have to send you this. I'm going to take a picture because I just paused our chat, and I have to send you this picture of your face with Tim because it is it's hilarious. It's perfect.
Thank you, everyone on Twitch, for showing up here. How are you today?
Hello, Twitchies.
How the hell are you?
I call you the Twitchies. Is that the Twitchies? Yes, good, right?
Twitchies. That sounds like
a good goof.
They got a drug problem, maybe.
I can't. Go back to the voice. I want to.
How about now?
So scary.
You sound great.
That is Nika. That is an extremely Tim and Jennifer .jpg picture. That's good.
Wait, we're switched on the overlay.
What?
Nika and I are switched on the overlay.
Tim?
Oh yeah, I'm Mike Bachmann tonight.
Nika, as far as I can tell, everything is correct.
Send me your character sheet.
Nika and Bachmann.
Oh, I didn't even look.
Look at this picture that Nika got. It's me and you, and how we always are.
Yeah, I didn't even look to see where I was putting people.
No, Nika's gonna give me her character sheet, and I'm gonna be real good at all her bonuses.
Yeah.
And stats.
Oops.
Nope, she'll never die. All
right.
Oh no, she
don't
will.
Die.
She will.
I just have so many hit points.
Yeah, you wanna? Hey, give me
5,
whatever.
5,000 hit points.
How many do you have?
Did I do it?
Legit.
Yeah, like total.
135.
Fuck. Oh, damn.
That is a lot. Well, actually, that's not that many more than me.
It's still, wait.
How many?
It's not.
I have 120.
What's your constitution? How do you have so many?
Because I have an 18 con.
Fuck. Yeah,
and I get a D10.
Yeah, that'll do.
How many?
And you probably roll better than me.
Tim, how many do you have?
I have like 100 or 98, something like that.
Ah, not the lowest.
I have 98.
He's a little wizard boy.
I should be the lowest.
He's a little boy.
I know, but I just don't want to be the lowest.
Why? I should have the lowest AC and I should have the lowest hit points.
I like
that. What's your AC? Oh.
Depends. Max is 17.
One of those. Oh, Max is okay.
Wait, was that? I did hear accent growl.
All right, that accent needs to shut the fuck up. It's making me hungry for some
Arby's. Tell accent to say hello to Addy.
I can.
She's accent. Licking her chops.
Addy, stop.
His
it.
Eyes are open. He's something just staring gross. Like he's trying to pretend.
He's just staring and pigging at you.
He's trying to pretend like he's not listening.
But you know he is. Isn't that funny?
You're not cool, accent.
Isn't that so funny? How you like? You just know
we're
he
gonna
is.
Get. Like he our does. 10th one-star review on iTunes.
Wow.
I love these people so much. I wish they would stop talking shit about Jesus. And it's my favorite podcast. I still hate that person. I don't hate the Jesus thing. Whatever. Obviously.
I hate Jesus.
Oh. We're just revealing little pieces of ourselves.
we're really into it tonight, aren't
we?
All right, we have to go around the circle and say something that has happened good this week, something that you're happy about. I'll start. I liked, I had a bourbon tasting at work, and that was fun, and I started playing For Honor, which is a video game on the PlayStation 4 that I'm playing, and it's a lot of fun, and content is reigning supreme. So that's some things that are happening this week for me, and I'm so happy.
I got this really good sweatshirt in the mail. It's got JoJo on it.
JoJo.
It's really good.
Did you get it at Redbubble?
I did.
So you know it's stolen.
Is that a small?
It's not stolen. Stolen. But they do love stealing on there, but this one's not stolen.
Oh, no.
And I've been watching a lot of RuPaul's Drag Race, and it's bringing a lot of joy to my life. And I got a bunch of deadlines out at work, so tomorrow I don't have a deadline. So that's good.
I get to drive to Cincinnati tomorrow, and I get to see my friends, and we are called the Trash Bags, and guess who is in that group?
You.
It's Bajaya.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm excited. Your Bajaya voice is rude. Oh, and I get to have brunch slash lunch with Brad on Sunday.
Oh, nice.
You know what? We should start having slash brunch, which is where we talk about all the gay shit we love. Mine's
that's
pharmacy.
Probably 100% what we'll do.
Wait, what? Oh, I see what you're saying.
Pharmacy.
That's such a good ship name. Fuck. Some ship names are really bad, but that's a good one.
They also go by Rocket Angel, I think, and something else.
The ship name in Captain Prince is like the worst one I've ever heard. It's Layman. Like, really? This is the name you choose? It's fucked up.
Anyway. Mike Bachmann, do you have anything nice to say?
Yeah. I actually, my favorite part was a minute ago when Tim started to say his favorite thing, and he started by just saying something that he liked. Like, here's something nice that happened to me this week. I like dogs.
You gotta take what you can get, man.
You know what? Dogs exist.
Delighting in
things
you like is very important for your mental health.
Yeah.
And I'm not gonna take your personal attack to heart. And that's another thing I'm gonna do this week. And and you're welcome for that.
Oh, man. Well, that's good, because it will not be the last.
Oh, boy.
Shit.
Someone does not read my Twitter.
No one does.
What happened to you, Thrifty?
Yeah, you can say.
Yeah, what's good?
What's good?
I got to really work on Geekly Taxes this week and writing up contracts for people.
That's also bad.
Yeah, Michael sucks.
That's it.
Be happy.
I'm going to see Nick Bristow next week. So that's fun.
That is
fun.
Okay,
and,
now let's
bring and I'm going to see Matthew Morris. I'm going to see Sarah Tompkins in the Dominican Columbus. Is that what it is?
Nice.
Very nice.
All right.
In Washington, D.C.
I don't think that fixed our energy. But
we're gonna
maybe we
right.
need it.
It's going to be okay.
Maybe we need to go the other way. Everybody say something bad that happened.
All right, you're all fucking right.
Oh, have you seen the government?
Have you been online?
My itches.
I have anal fissures.
I keep rubbing lotion on it.
I got worms.
I feel like dying, any of those options. Oh, no, that's shit. Really sad.
And she's like, she's losing so much weight.
She's stop. Okay, I'm gonna actually get upset.
But no. She's still, her dead body would be really fucking heavy.
One day we're gonna wake up and she's just gonna be dead in the bed. And then we're gonna be like, what do you do with a dead dog in the city?
I'll throw her in the trash can, I guess.
No, take her to your vet.
I'm Googling
like,
that
Like, hey,
right
I got this dog. It seems extremely dead. Can you do anything about that? Like, no, we're gonna set her on fire.
I don't want to carry a dead dog 3 blocks to my zip car. And I don't know if you're even allowed to bring a dead dog in a zip car. Another thing I must Google.
I'm pretty sure. Put her in a blanket and take her to your vet.
Yeah, it's not gonna happen. You're gonna be at the vet, and they're gonna put her to sleep.
Or she's just gonna die in her sleep.
And you're gonna have to hold her paw while it happens, and it's gonna be it's gonna be way worse.
No, she's like making eye contact. She's like, this is the place where I get butt.
Okay, you y'all really actually gotta stop crying.
Why are we doing this? This is the worst. This is so stupid. The next 200. Here we go. No, we have to talk about something good.
Okay, guys, let's go back around and say something good that happened to get out of that.
I'm great now. I feel like I've let out a lot of venom and.
Oh God.
I feel like my skin's hot.
What if I just drink the rest of this fucking cocktail right?
Do it, Jennifer.
Oh my God.
I'm not going to.
I've already had several ounces of whisk.
Let's play a drinking game tonight. Every time somebody speaks, you take a shot.
Okay.
Okay.
We should just play Drinking Quest. You know, it's a Thursday.
Should. I loved it.
That's why don't we
just,
it
let's
work.
Just release that as an episode.
We should. No, but all right, let's go. We've been doing this for almost an hour.
Yeah, we have really been dragging this out.
Okay.
I've missed all you so much.
Someone said this is my first full live show. Oh, I'm no! sorry, you had to find this one.
We usually are less morbid.
Less morbid.
Yeah.
I will say that a lady downstairs who works for me, who I dislike very much, brought in her her extremely adorable
dead dog
puppy. No, it was a puppy. It was a border collie puppy, and it was the only meeting I've ever enjoyed with her.
Oh, so. Nice.
Aww.
That was good.
One of my doggies at home is half border collie, half black.
Oh, my God. Thing was killing me.
I think dogs are cute. That's my opinion.
I think dogs are good.
I also think cats are cute, and I wish I wasn't so allergic.
I like cats because they're fucking rude, and I respect that about them.
I don't love that part of it.
I need more dependent animals. I need to constantly feel like something actually loves me, so.
Don't get a greyhound.
Addie would not be good for that.
Don't get a greyhound, because she's like a giant weird cat that lives with us. It is also our roommate.
How many other new people do we have in the chat tonight? We got Mike McCanahan, which I've enjoyed your... I've enjoyed your reviews. Not all of them.
I love whenever he sends little ones, and I'm always like, with his picture, it reminds me of like cool news anchor is like listening to us, and I feel so fancy.
It's wonderful.
Like,
hey, everybody, who has Audacity open?
What?
I have the origin open. I'm playing Mass Effect.
I ain't opening dick
for you.
40.
We're doing great.
That's all I know about Mass Effect.
I might have to get a drink again.
Are we ready? Is everyone ready?
No, I'm not.
Oh my god.
For some reason, my Windows like search function is hella slow. I don't think it's indexed properly.
Test.
So like, I type.
How do you
Audacity
fix that? Because my downloads always look, and I even moved all the porn I bought off that.
Wait, you bought porn?
Well, you support art, and they give it to you. You support art, and they're like.
You can like you can force Windows to reindex, but I forget where you go to do it.
There's someone in your house.
I know. All right, on go.
Oh my God.
Three, two, one, go. We're recording.
Recording a podcast.
Michael, I didn't tell you that I had Audacity open, so why did we go so soon?
Are you serious,
Bachmann?
I mean, no, it was open. But like I didn't.
I asked. I said, "Does everyone have Audacity open?"
Yeah, you did. And then I said, "No, I don't have it." And then we got talking about other things, and you said, "Okay, let's go."
Well, I assumed that with, because you're such a conscientious young man, that in that period of time you would have opened it.
When, okay, in like the, what, 5 years? Is it 5 years yet of doing it's this? When have I ever given you an indication that you could rely on me for anything?
Every time we ever recorded.
Girl.
Don't you, I know you in your secret heart.
All tea, all shade. What? I'm just going to keep saying repulsive because I just started watching it. Let's pretend it's like 2005 or whenever the hell RuPaul was around.
2005, yeah. Whoops. I installed an extension. Our extension's good? Wait, sure. What's our opinion on that? Goddamn. I love that we get more than 100 viewers now without being rated or whatever it's called.
And without... it being a special episode. Maybe it is a special episode.
It is a special episode. They're all special episodes.
So special. Well, this is the first one into our 200s.
Yeah. Did we? Is this going to have a message about like some disease or like social problem at the end? Like
on a very special episode of Drunks and Dragons.
We do have that disease we have to deal with. There's a lot of pending quests.
Yeah, and I'm really the quest log is really chock full right now.
What is it, Colin's called like the Gramp or the Grump?
The Gramp? He's just actually really good. Actually, Gramp? Michael, I don't know because Toby doesn't know because you killed my character.
Oh. I didn't kill your character. Your friend.
Yeah, you did. Maybe if you...
I don't know what you're talking about, Tim. We never killed Harper.
I'm just saying, maybe if those messages weren't clear.
Oh my god.
What else do we want to bring up? Just kidding. Come on. We're having fun here.
I need Listen, to I got a dope new character sheet that I'd love to talk about, so yeah, we should get this shit on the road.
Damn.
Have you read it yet?
Out of a day.
I have too much snot in my body.
Oh, where, like, in what parts of your body? Where specifically is the snot?
I keep putting in my dick. Maybe that's why it itches.
You got that's the disease that we're talking about in this special episode of Drunks and Dragons.
Gramps.
Okay. It has other names, you know.
I don't know. I'm dead.
It's like in different parts of the world, it's called different things.
What are you guys talking about now?
Yeah, that disease?
It's a disease.
Dick's not. Dick's not.
Is it called juice?
All right, let's do this.
It's called the Gramp, but you know, some people call it sludge blood. Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
Okay, on go.
On go.
Three, two.
Okay. Do we need to have a quick stretch so that we can?
No.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
No, don't make me do an improv game. I'll commit a murder upon What's... you.
you're doing me a concern.
I can bamboozle me here.
All right,
you thought I was giraffe, but am pupper.
All right, I'm gonna start now.
Okay.
Greetings, adventurers. You have joined us for another episode of the Drunks and Dragons podcast. I am your dungeon master, Michael DiMauro, and with me is Nika Howard.
I literally was saying in my head, don't say my name first. Don't say my name first, because I had no idea what the fuck
Always
I was going to say.
You first. I smell weakness, and then I... Jennifer Cheeks here.
Hey, everyone.
Timothy Lanning.
Hey, everyone. It's great to be here. Thanks for having me.
And Mike Bachmann.
Hey, guys. It's me. I'm about to play Steve for, like, the fourth time.
he's back, and he's pissed.
In a world.
Where Steve
Nika,
will not
you weren't
fucking
ready
die.
Last time. Did you know that?
No, I was ready last time. I wasn't ready the time before.
No,
all anxiety.
It was last time. I called you first, and you were like, don't call me. And then Mike Bachmann made a goof. Remember? I don't remember that.
Time? I didn't make shit.
No. Time doesn't mean anything here in the world of podcasts.
Yeah, Michael, fuck you.
that's like fair. A long time ago, to
it
be
was
fair.
At least 2 weeks ago, and I can't remember anything that happened today.
Everyone,
I've become older and wiser since then.
It's so good to see you. It's been so long.
I feel older and stupider since 2 weeks ago. My brain is sort of leaking out my ears.
I'm constantly getting smarter, stronger, and faster every day. So,
Jennifer, you were sick last time.
Oh, I had the flu. That's
are you feeling better?
Yes, aww. I'm normal. So literally everyone in our house has been sick now. I had the flu. Tim got a cold. Eddie
Man
had
cold.
Mystery dog disease. Now
Eddie ate Honey Nut Cheerio.
I fed her 2 Honey Nut Cheerios and she nearly died.
Yep.
But now everyone in our home is well, knock on wood.
What about you?
What about me?
What kind of illnesses have you had in the past 2 weeks?
I'm just gonna ignore that conversation because I feel like it'll jinx things.
Should we have talked about this thing that you emailed me about before we started?
Hey guys.
Hey.
Wait.
Did you not have 5 minutes? We're talking shit to each other, and we didn't even bring up something that we should have brought up.
That sounds like us.
Oops. All right. Well, now pause for editing. Okay, when Tim does that, that means really edit it out. Who's ever editing this one? I think David. Yeah. Okay. Hey guys.
Hey Michael.
Hey.
Did you know that one of our OG slabbers is publishing a book? Well, he's not publishing it. He wrote a book.
Uh-huh. I didn't know that. Tell me more about it. I love books.
Do you like books that have sci-fi in them?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Love it.
Well, this book is called Space Tripping. It comes out March 7th, and it is sci-fi and comedy.
That's my two favorite things. March and 7th.
It is... So Patrick Edwards is the guy who is writing it.
Okay.
He listened to us from back in the beginning. You can follow him on Twitter at Rambling Waffle. And you can check out more about his book at spacetrippingbook.com.
Okay.
But essentially, it is a space opera. And it won, again, pause for editing. And it won a contest that was co-hosted by Inkshares and Nerdist.
What?
That's very cool.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, that's awesome.
Crazy. It's insane.
It's a pretty big deal.
So while we haven't read said book, it sounds like it's a pretty good book for our listeners and me, who doesn't listen.
So, okay. So we've got the inside track here. We've got the inside skinny. Mm-hmm. If you wait, I hate to tell people to wait to buy things, but if you wait until March 7th, when the book comes out, you can actually go to inkshares.com and search for Space Tripping and get it for free.
What?
Just for, this is only, we're only telling like you guys. Only you guys.
You're very
for
special free? To our hearts. And maybe for free. The best, including
what
free
kind
books.
Of business model is that?
Just for that one day. So like go and do it and then like get the numbers up real high and download it. Cause so then we'll look good and he'll be happy. And then read it. Cause
let's all just help each other out. Come on.
And we need to read more books, in my opinion. That's
I haven't
my
read
opinion.
Personally a book in quite a while, so perhaps I'll read the book.
Jennifer, this how is probably even... like a fan fiction. But
ooh,
no.
I like those. So all right.
How do you even write a book? Like, I mean, I get as far as opening up Acrobat Reader, and then I can't get any further than that. It
Michael
won't let me type.
Bachmann, that's because you need to open up Acrobat Writer.
Oh. Tell me more. This turns into an ad for Acrobat.
Well,
but, Acrobat is a great program.
Just to leave you all with just a little bit of how on brand this is, imagine Guardians of the Galaxy with characters who are drunk and say fuck a lot.
Okay.
So
that sounds good.
That sounds like our brand.
Yeah,
that
sounds
exactly.
pretty on brand. We actually might need to talk to our copyright lawyers. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying.
Coming after your ass.
I mentioned our copyright lawyers on Pope Zone. He lives in New York.
Mm-hmm. We have two lawyers.
We have our IP lawyer and have our other friends. Lawyer. Very. Damn. One of them lives in New York.
Whoa! That means that he's good at lawyering.
But I live in New York. Does he live in real New York? Is
New
that
York
what you're saying?
City.
Oh, real New York.
All right. Thank you so much, and have a great one. I'll see you next episode.
Yeah. So just go to go to inkshares.com and search for Space Tripping. You can find it. It's actually available all the other places you would think, like Amazon and Target, Barnes and Noble, all that crap.
Places. So,
and you know, and that's the end of the ad. But here's another note for you. If you want to get an ad, you probably want to do it soon before we figure out that a 30-second ad shouldn't be 4 minutes.
We're really fucking bad at it. So get in while we're real bad at it still.
Yeah, and obviously we're only taking the highest quality of ads, so thank you so much. I love you.
Send us quality ads.
Just like good wine.
Like Kroger? Kroger, if you're listening, Winn-Dixie,
please.
Really any of the grocery stores, Hy-Vee.
I like Trader Joe's.
Come on, get some Hy-Vee.
I don't know.
Get out of the Walmart.
We have to stop. We're going to get yelled at. We have to stop. We have to stop. I'm going to roll a d20.
Okay, yeah, just go ahead and roll it. Let's fucking do it.
Trywink.com/D&D.
Try Schnooks. It's a good grocery store.
I rolled a 5.
18, Michael. I think. Or 16.
Oh, shit. Was,
I rolled
18. That?
Nice.
Fuck. Somebody should have told me we rolled dice at the beginning of the podcast. I didn't know.
That's our fault.
Yeah, that's on you. 11.
Did I roll the highest?
You did. Jennifer goes to me today. What did we do last week? And I'm like, what? It was kind of a big deal. One, pick not the, that much. Three big things.
Two. Pick pick the person who was hopped up on cold medicine because they had the flu real bad.
Yeah, Tim.
You dunked me.
Oh, now you feel bad. Well, I'll tell you what.
Sleep on the couch.
Fucking now. Happened. We were fighting the wretched traitor Jett and all
guy.
His minions. That piece of garbage. We did kill a good number of his friends, and then
did we?
I
think technically Steve did.
Wait, say it again.
Did we do murder? Or
no, I think.
Wait, repeat what you just said because I was spacing out for a minute.
I said that we fought the wretched traitor,
Jett,
and that we killed some of his friends, but maybe we didn't do murder.
I don't think we killed any of them.
I don't think you killed anyone.
No. I'm thinking of the guards from before. 18... We did kill the innocent guards, but we did not kill the bad guys.
Well, we're mostly focused on Jett, and then a red bear killed everyone else.
You ran them off, though.
Yeah, that was the important thing. And Jett, the fucking coward traitor, ran away.
I feel like we always do representing Jett. You know, now that since he's not here to defend himself, I feel like, you know, somebody should be his advocate, and it has to be me.
I mean, he can come back.
His official name
finish
is
the job.
Jett, the fucking coward traitor.
And I always knew he was a coward traitor, and that's on me for not voicing my opinion.
You really fucked that one really up, Tim/Toby, whoever you are.
Toby knew it.
But the most important thing that happened last episode is that at the very end, the horrible, horrible, fucked up face of Steve the Gnoll, well, new Steve, his
Focus.
Voice came through. Focus, Steve, please tell us more about this, Michael Bachmann. I think that's what needs to happen right now.
Oh, well, I mean, for right now, all you've seen is the head of Focus, so I don't feel like...
But we heard his voice!
In good conscience. Yeah, I mean, you did hear his voice. I mean, it could just be somebody from the same Melloncamp who has that same dialect.
True. You know, I thought you saw his face.
You saw the face of Focus. How does
but
that
I feel
tell
like,
you it's Steve?
I feel like Jaela knows Steve. Jaela and Steve have a history. So if that's Steve's voice, I feel like she would know it from being Steve and not another Melloncamp.
Right.
I
think but Jaela's heart is dark and painted these days.
I don't know why you would say that.
So, okay. So, and we didn't, we discussed this a little bit, but Mike Bachmann.
Yeah.
Is the voice going to be Steve's voice? Because it doesn't have to be. It's going through different vocal cords.
Yeah. It's very tough to say. And I feel like because of, like, you know, I needed you guys to like know instantly who it was, you know, then I had to do that voice, but I don't know. I won't know until I open my mouth to speak.
Like maybe Steve can do it when he really tries hard.
Yeah.
Like he's doing
it.
Didn't
Tom have Steve's voice though?
That's true. He did.
Yeah. He'd switch between them.
Yeah. So
he did. But I mean, even though the body parts in the freezer were preserved, they weren't like there wasn't any like double seal Ziploc or like you know these weren't in these in gallon bags.
Yeah,
it's like there's nothing to protect them from like degeneration. Yeah, even though they are preserved, so it may not work the same.
No, I mean it sounds like science and vetted. I like that.
Vetted. It's a fucking buzzword.
We also leveled up.
We also leveled up.
Should we talk about that?
Heck yeah.
Before we get into
Let's talk about that.
We didn't sleep yet, and I'm planning on getting nasty. Just kidding. No, we can talk about that.
I mean, mine's not super exciting, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I mean, it's 5e. Only every fourth level is.
I got 11 extra hit points.
Hey.
I'm at 120 now.
Nice.
A fun thing is that now I have this power where plants and animals like love me more and are much less likely to fight me.
Oh, the Tim Lanning power.
Yeah. It's called Nature Sanctuary, and it says creatures of the natural world sense your connection to nature and become hesitant to attack you. When a beast or plant creature attacks you, that creature must make a wisdom saving throw against your warden spell save DC. And on a failed save, they had to choose someone else to fight.
Nice.
So, like, what awesome. Constitutes as a beast character? That's what I want to know.
I think it says in the Dungeon Master's or so the Monster Manual.
Just like point and be like, "This is a beast," and then they can't fight me.
Be like, "This guy is real hairy."
Yeah, exactly.
I think he's a beast.
Yeah, so I'm basically just able to like walk through the forest now, and like little squirrels like land on my shoulders, and the butterflies and everything. Like,
you became a Disney princess.
I'm
this
a Disney
level.
Fucking princess, and also an extremely sturdy dwarf who loves eating burritos and drinking. So, pretty much your dream woman.
That's 100% what Disney needs.
Yeah. Dwarf represent.
Who wants to go next?
Well, Jaela did. Get a few extra hit points. And then I got Cleansing Touch, which for the number of times per day equal to my charisma modifier, I can remove one spell from that is ongoing from myself or a willing creature.
Nice.
And as I said off the air, she did this specifically so that Jett couldn't do heat metal on her again.
I didn't even get to pick this. This is just what level 14 does. I got to pick nothing about
Okay, Nika.
Like, you didn't choose to play this type of character.
This has been your plan all this along.
Hold on.
Evil mastermind.
I'll go next. So, since I leveled up, I automatically get for free two new spells. I chose Magic Missile and Project Image. That being said, I will be finding a spell book. If I have to drive this fucking podcast into the ground for the next four episodes.
I don't know where you would find a spell book.
That's been already alluded to. That it's like about it's too. It's
I can't even imagine in this area of this wizard tower that you're in.
I know
where you would find a spell book. Seems unlikely.
Yeah, I accidentally forgot to pick a single attack lower than third level. I'm like, battles is tough. Yeah. But more importantly. 14th level is the most important level for a wizard. And
tell us why
it's when he becomes a man.
It's when he becomes a man. Today is Toby's birthday, as you know. Toby is still 39. But Toby has now gained the ability that's called illusory reality. I actually put ILL. I don't have the whole thing in front of me. It's one of those two. Basically, I can make one of my illusions real.
What
do you mean real?
So
what do you mean by that? Can you give him a backstory?
He's gonna make a Pinocchio and turn him into a real
boy. Can your illusions love? Is that what you're saying?
Well, I mean, I don't think it goes that deep. It's not magical, and magic is the number one, and love is number one magic. We can all agree to that. But something simple is I could make a wall. And usually before I would make a fake wall, and then the monsters would have to make like a check. And then if they got the check correct, they would touch the wall and be like, "Yo, it's fake." Now they'll be like, "Yo, it's fake. Oh shit, but it's real." Meaning they can't get through the wall.
Damn.
Or
well, then what if they break? What if they try to break the wall? Then what happens?
Well, they would have to do a strength DC against stone or whatever.
Moment in time, it's real.
What if you make a man whose dad left him, and does it create the dad? And does it alter time so that his dad did, in fact, leave him?
Well,
when he was a young baby.
That's fucked up. Yeah, it does, actually, but it's not magical. So.
For that moment, his entire family is real, and then they disappear into the ether.
If you got 12 hours, I can get you a dad. Toby can get you a dad.
Like, what if you don't love, you don't, like, you're getting with this girl, right? Okay. And you don't really love her.
Oh, okay.
But you cast this spell on this fake love. That you have for her.
No, again, not love. I cannot address enough that I cannot do love.
Love is magical, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, but I cannot create magical objects. It's a magical object that is a non-magical property. Does that make sense?
Are you saying you can't create love?
I can't create love.
Well, that is a bleak outlook you've got on this life, dude.
I can't. I cannot stress enough. You're right. I can make a fleshlight that is 5 feet tall.
Oh my god!
But I cannot make a love.
You can make.
Can you make a jerk yurt?
I can.
For 1 minute,
kind of make a jerk yurt.
But only for a minute.
It's a shitty jerk yurt.
It's nothing like the OG jerk yurt, which. Guys, we don't have access to the jerk yurt anymore.
Fuck.
No.
For the sake of the podcast, thank God. Thank baby Jesus.
Why, Michael, why do you want us to be sad and not have our beautiful jerk yurt? Now we're Aludra and Jaela supposed to get their private time.
Michael, why don't you like the jerk cut?
That's all for me. Oh, and I got 7 hit points.
Nice.
Well, let's not talk about Steve since.
Oh, okay.
You guys are just about to meet Steve.
Yeah.
I know.
So we're all standing there.
We don't even know what's gonna happen, right? Because you guys just see a face.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe. So
a face maybe pops through, and Toby takes his giant water globe and smashes it into the face.
All right, roll it.
We're the same combat, so as we all know, my initiative last time was 29.
Roll initiative.
Wait, are you actually doing that?
Yeah, I'm actually doing that. I said it in chat.
Chat, it's real.
Do I have to roll initiative?
Are we all rolling initiative?
Well, yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Toby started combat. You have to get him to stop combat, or you have to fight Steve to the death.
Well, I guess he doesn't know who Toby or who Steve is.
Role play. I got 20 total, not nat 20, just 20 total.
I got 7.
I got an 8.
What did Toby get?
12.
I thought you were going to say 30 at first.
34.
God damn.
I get to add 30 to all my rolls now.
don't question it, it's just real.
Okay, so...
38.
But I get Steve... a surprise round.
Oh, okay. You get a surprise round.
I smash
what if Toby accidentally kills.
But you only saw his face essentially.
Yeah,
so.
I hit him in the fucking face.
How big is Thug's face? I forget.
Not that it's normal human size.
I'll have you know.
Head, I was picturing the most huge, horrible face coming out. Like he's the fucking caterpillar from Alice in Wonderland with his big old face.
And the rest of his body is all weird.
I don't like it. I don't want to know.
He's very low.
What if we Wilson Steve the Gnoll for the rest of the show and we just never know what his body, a reverse Wilson, if you will.
Oh my god.
But he shows his face, but the rest of the, wait.
It's exact Wilson.
It's just that we get to see the bottom of his face, not his, well, we see Wilson's ass often. They just don't show his mouth. Anyways,
or his butt mouth. Can
for those
you
playing along at home, making a reference to a TV show from the 90s, which had was called Tool. No, Tool Time was on the show. Home Improvement.
My mom always called it Tool Time.
Everyone's parents called it Tool Time.
Yeah. No, my mom was special.
Was.
Okay. So what does your attack do to Steve?
Steve has to make a strength saving throw of 18.
Oh, no.
I feel like you can only see his face, though, so I don't know how all this water's getting in there.
Same fucking way I got the jet. Did you listen to last episode?
No, I didn't.
Okay, I throw water. It goes through rocks, because that's what water does, and a sphere gets hit face. If he fails, he gets pushed up in the air.
He's not even in the room with you. Yeah. That's all I'm saying.
Who gives a shit? Neither his face is.
21.
You do it. So you get splashed with water, and I push you backwards.
Back into the rocks?
Yeah,
I'm in rocks.
Yeah, you get pushed backwards to an unoccupied space.
But it's occupied by rocks.
Well, not everywhere. You came from somewhere.
No, I came out of a pile of rocks. I'm literally surrounded on all sides by rocks.
Tunneling through the rocks.
Then
to
he
get
gets
to you.
Shot out of it. The closest thing is him being geysered on top of in front of us. Okay.
So is this where I describe Steve's body?
Yes! The worst way to... Oh, this is a terrible mistake. I didn't know I was joking Steve onto the scene. That's not what I wanted.
Okay, this is gonna be this is going to be interesting because, true story, I have a list of all of the body parts that I have available to me, but I have not fully decided.
Oh,
roll dice.
No,
no, I can't. There's not that many variety. There's not that much variety, oh, okay, in, like, types of body parts. Like, I can't just use a head as my leg or any shit like
if
that.
If you don't have more than two arms, I'm going to be super mad at you.
And Michael, be careful. What you accrue at the beginning of the podcast is what you'll reap all year. Remember that. Toby can make magic items that are very powerful, and maybe...
Wait, he can make magic items?
And Toby can?
Steve has...
I made a fucking Ghostbuster detector, and I warned you, like, dog, this is a bad idea. And you're like, you did it. I'm like, all right, I make mushroom-powered Ghostbusting
equipment.
Well,
I can't wait to meet Steve that has 15 arms.
I think you guys, like, you guys may be embellishing, like, what actually was in this freezer, because it wasn't quite that many things. Now I will say that you know, maybe the first thing that I should tell you is that Steve may have parts that he had to scavenge, mm-hmm, you know, that weren't originally in the freezer.
Okay.
Through some hard times.
Wow, that's dark.
Yeah, it was tough. It was tough for our buddy Steve. He of course has a head of Thokus. Yeah, you all know that. I'm gonna say, let's see.
What does Thokus's head look like?
Yeah, can you remind
like?
Us?
Yeah.
Doug, Thokus is your character, your creation. You guys,
okay, but apparently, according to Twitter, I didn't describe him very well. So
right, so do it.
Oh, let's throw it on Twitter.
Twitter's pro.
I thought you would want to describe.
You know, I would love to, but Michael, this is what's called collaboration. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to need you to describe to me.
I don't think this is what collaboration is.
I think you should make a Twitter poll. And
ugliest person you have ever seen.
I imagine
you're
looking like Sloth.
That is fair.
Wait,
that
no.
Is
well, yes, that's what he looks yeah. like now. But Thokus, yeah, good Thokus probably just look like fucking warrior guy.
But he's been in that fridge for a long time.
Jennifer, whom did I say from the Berserk anime?
Oh, he looks like General Add-on.
General Add-on.
From Berserk. I think that's 100% true.
Thokus, he may have been a semi-attractive man in his time. Mm-hmm. But when your head is lopped off and put in a freezer, it's no longer your time, I'm afraid to say.
He's right. A lumpy boy.
Like I think he was bald.
He was bald. Okay. Well, no longer is because of the mold.
True. Could have some moldy hair.
Yikes. Ew.
I imagine his skin is kind of like looser, and maybe he's got a little hangdog kind of look. Like his
hangdog.
Little droopy.
Can you see it's
this? It's loose.
Does he look like this?
Yeah.
I can't see it.
That skin is too tight and attractive for me.
You want him to be looser. You want him to be a looser boy.
Well, earlier Thokus.
Yo, yeah, in his prime. Okay. Clearly that's what Thokus looked like. Anime as fuck.
Yeah. Yeah.
But he, you know, his skin is loose. It's going to be kind of discolored in many areas. And just kind of, you know, kind of saggy and floppy, I'd say.
Another floppy boy?
Right.
I'm now informing Steve's voice, I think. But, His body is very patchwork. It's going to be, you know, you may not recognize much of what you see there because it's just small patches. It's kind of not easy. You do notice that he has two arms that look like they belong to an owlbear at one point.
Googling owlbear arms. Okay.
You're getting the cops called on this.
Yeah, they are going to think that I did several murders. So.
He's flying out of his hole that he was once encased in. You're gonna see at the bottom of where his patchwork body is. You're going to see two frog's legs.
This is very messed up.
From Primple.
They look like they once belonged to a Primple Thumble. You know, Aludra may recognize that.
No, I've seen those legs before.
Yeah,
I can recognize those legs anywhere.
Between those legs, and I'm so sorry.
No.
I'm so sorry.
No, don't. Just please, come on, man.
Shut up, Tim. I need to
listen.
This.
Listen, you're right. In between those legs, in the front, is kind of small, like modest. If you were to fingerprint Steve's dick, you would find out that it once belonged to a guard. That worked for Trant Thumble.
Oh boy!
And so his dick is just out there.
His dick is just a finger. You know, because he wanted to feel. wanted to feel normal.
Yeah.
And so that's what he needed. You know, that's what normal meant to Steve.
That's Steve's work? Normal, not our
Steve
normal.
Steve is like, this is I've seen a dick, and this is definitely,
this is
what,
definitely
it
what a
like.
Dick looks like.
Does yeah. it like, can he like kind of grab stuff?
Yeah.
You know what? Okay.
Can he pee from it?
No, because interesting thing, Steve is a Warforged, technically. Now Warforged only in that, you know, like
a
flesh golem, yeah. It would have been broken. So it'd be Warforged. So he doesn't need to eat or drink. Okay. So he also doesn't need pee or poo holes.
Okay.
Nice. That's why he got a fingy there.
Instead of a robot, he's a Frankenstein's monster.
Right. On the back.
And, you know, Reddit coined the phrase, he's a flesh golem. Did we discuss that?
Oh, fuck that shit.
That's the best thing I've heard.
on the backside, opposite.
Oh, and how's he going to make his butt? I'm terrified.
Well, and that's the thing, is that he's got the tail of a dragonborn. Which may not be in the proper location because, again, he doesn't have a poo hole. He didn't really know. You know, normally you're going to make a tail. You're going to put it right above your butthole.
That's not how I aim tails when I'm doing tail play.
Have you ever even played pin the tail on the donkey?
Yeah, I'm not typically looking for the asshole, but I'm not very good at it.
You peek out of your blindfold. You look for the butthole.
Where's that brown?
And then you pin the tail right above it.
Yes,
but he does have it, and it's just kind of in, like, you can't really tell why it's in the wrong place, but it's definitely in the wrong place.
Yeah, you can't put your dick finger
on
it.
It's like the uncanny valley of tail positions.
For right. those playing along at home, this is not Tom's tail. It's from when you guys traveled back in time, and there was lots of Toms.
So it's
a Tom's tail.
Is it a Tom's tail or is it just a dragonborn's tail?
They were all clones. They were all clones of Tom.
It's not the dude that you fought with, Ren, and what's his nuts?
The only thing that survived of Tom, I believe, was, did his dick survive?
I think that's true. I thought his tail did.
Yeah, no, I think his tail, it's petrified and
Bucky had it.
Oh, that's right. Okay. So yeah, no, his dick didn't survive. I tried to get Jaela to cut his dick off, she was a little preoccupied.
But that destroyed Blood Drinker, if I remember correctly.
Yes. Yeah.
The only thing more powerful than Blood Drinker.
So is Steve's not wearing any clothes?
Just fucking nude as hell.
He's got equipment. He definitely has equipment.
Okay, but
which, like
some,
I mean,
tasteful like anime-like openings.
He's got a breastplate on, no pants. What do you pull up in here?
I mean, I could describe his equipment if you'd like, but, you know, it's...
I was just more commenting on his finger dick hanging out.
Can I just, like, catalog what we've got here real quick? Mm-hmm. We have got ourselves a just terrifying flesh golem Frankenstein Winnie the Pooh hybrid with a finger dick because he's got, like, a breastplate on and no pants.
I don't like it.
Right. Well,
does Aludra recognize Slocus's like fucked up face though? Because it's been like a long time.
I think she does.
Okay.
I think she would. I would just, you know what? Just like rewind it a second.
Yeah. Because
there's at least like one person out there going, "What is happening?"
Oh, sure.
I think there's more than one person.
Okay, I think
there's probably
like
a couple
of
people on the podcast that have the same.
Yeah.
For those playing along, I don't know. Should Steve explain?
Do you want me to give you a recap of Steve's history real quick?
Please.
Like, well, let's continue out the scene, kids.
I think, are you going to continue combat, Steve?
I think you can
talk to this small man who's attacking you.
No.
I think, you know, I'm flying through the air, I would be like, you know, and fuck it. It's Steve's voice, I guess. Aludra, is he with you?
Yeah. I almost called you Bucky just then.
Because
you're just so small. Toby. We know him. We know him.
What the fuck is this thing? Oh my god.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm a little confused right now, but I recognize this face and I recognize that voice. I do not recognize the rest of these.
Michael, do I have my ghost busting mushroom? My mushroom trap. My rad. With me?
Sure. Yeah, you still have your rad.
So my rad's going crazy, right?
No.
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing anymore. What's my... Okay, well, that's actually maybe a good thing. I don't know. Let me edit some.
If I had it all to do again, I think Steve would have instead said, "This guy bothering you?"
About Toby?
Yeah.
That is a great first line. So, this guy messing with you?
Toby, you look at your machine and you realize that this monster is not the source of the magical disturbance.
What the hell is this gross monstrosity?
Well,
I have a name.
It's Steve.
Steve?
Steve, what's... I don't understand. I can hear your voice, but how are you here right now?
Oh, it's been a long road.
I can see from the many, many body parts you have going on.
Why are you not hitting him?
He's our friend. I thought he was dead.
At this point, I believe something else enters the room.
Oh, yeah. Oh, fuck. Yeah. You see kind of like a half flesh, half mechanical. If you've ever seen Toy Story and you've seen the baby with the spider legs, it's much akin.
Oh,
but
no.
Atop the spider legs, you see the bust, the shoulders, head, and neck of a bugbear, which, as Tim described, is much akin to an Ewok. So an Ewok if it had mechanical spider legs.
Oh my god.
I'm not going to attack that. I'm just going to assume that this is part of all this. This is the worst day of my life.
When I say it enters the room, it walks down the wall.
Why?
Toby is horrified. He's having a bad day. But he's also very intrigued. What?
All the blood drains from Aludra's face. And she's like trying to be chill. But she's obviously losing her cool right now.
Steve noticing this, he goes, "Oh, don't worry, that's just Jerry."
Jerry.
Here, boy.
So what is a Jerry? Yeah, what's a Jerry?
Jerry is my construct because I am now an artificer.
Oh, so you made this.
Yeah, thing. Which as you may remember, well, one of the two, either Thokus or Mjolnir, it was an artificer. Either way,
yeah,
okay. So Mjolnir's head does exist somewhere as part of Steve. It's just not really visible. So I have the knowledge of an artificer, which is, you know, how I got to be as I am today.
So is this your companion? Your pet?
Oh yeah, I made him. He's great. He's kept me company for these long 5 years.
Oh wow!
I trained under artificers, and they didn't do anything like this.
Oh yeah, no, artificers make you get to make a construct at a certain level. I forget.
Yeah, but this is a dead creature, and oh, this is bad.
I should point out it is large enough to ride because one of my options was a construct was a female steeder, which is part spider but also is mountable.
We all just like had this moment of silence, just like considering this.
I ride this thing. Oh
my God. Steve, how did you survive being separated from Tom?
I wish I knew. I mean, that's been part of my quest is, to find out just what happened to me. Tom said he was going to get me out of his head, and he was a hero. He stayed true to his word. We went to see a man, and then the next thing I know, I woke up as part of this thing.
Oh, so you didn't do this. Well, this was done. You woke up and you were like this.
Tom saved me.
What man is this? Tom creation is what we're looking at here. Well, Tom's definitely a hero, and he's very great. What man did you talk to? He sounds like a very powerful wizard.
I don't know. Where's Tom? He can tell you.
Oh no.
Tom, is he with you? Aludra, is Tom with you?
I thought you knew.
Knew Knew what?
Well, our good friend Tom, he really is a hero.
I agree.
He saved the world when the demons poured through the portal. And Steve, I'm really sorry to tell you, but he passed away. He's gone.
He died?
Yeah. Yeah, like 5 years ago, actually.
The record shows literally, the demon apocalypse. And yeah, everyone knows Tom. He's the biggest hero ever.
Okay.
Steve, literally, walks forward and, she puts her hand on Steve, but she does not like it. She's clearly, she's trying
I'm gonna
to muscle
need
through
you
it.
To, I'm going to need you to roll some sort of, some sort of wisdom or something.
I just realized we never said that Steve landed. Is this all happening while he's flying through the air, or did he? Is it safe to say he landed?
He probably landed. Probably. Yeah, he definitely landed.
Is this all within 6 seconds?
I'm trying to see what I should roll.
Probably Constitution, right?
Survival.
Survival with nature. Yeah.
What do you think, Michael?
Well, what'd you roll?
Well, I haven't rolled yet.
Constitution.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
Oh, not great. 11.
Oh, you get a plus 3. You're by me.
14.
I'll say that you at least make a nice gesture towards Steve without actually bringing yourself to touch his horrible visage.
He's like, she kind of pats the air near him.
I'm sorry I hit you with that water. Hi, I'm Toby Treacletart. I too studied some artificery, but I preferred illusion magic. Do you forgive me for attacking you? I get you are terrible to behold, but I guess if these two trust you and they're the greatest heroes, third and fourth greatest heroes of all time.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
King Titus Harper, yes.
You know what? Absolutely. I mean, I understand. I kind of startled you, which is my fault. Absolutely. The only one I know here, the only two people I know here is Aludra and Jaela. I didn't recognize Jaela right away because she seems angry for some reason. But, Toby, your name's Toby, right?
Hi, I'm Toby.
Oh, hi, Toby. I'm Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Anybody who's going out of his way to protect Aludra is a friend of mine. I think Aludra's great, and I think you're great.
Oh, thanks. How did you end up in my house?
Steve, is that you?
Yeah, it's me.
You see an old man. He burrows through the rubble and pops out, and you recognize him as Old Man Weck.
Steve. I like that our reaction to Old Man Weck is basically it's like Jason from Arrested Development.
I need you to further clarify. Where did the body parts come from?
Oh my god.
Hi, I'm Toby. I'm not gonna attack you. Maybe that's slightly racist. Oh, I gotta think.
He's trying to ask him some
Wait,
questions.
You want me to know where the You want to know where, who the body parts came from, or?
Yeah, what's going on here? This whole thing's confusing. I feel like I'm confused as to why. You would be a strange meat construction.
Oh, sure. Well, it's a long story, but I'll make it short. I was in a party with some other people, one of which was Jaela, and I don't remember the other ones. It was a long time ago. And then I died by touching an old book. And then my friend, Tom the Dragonborn, he touched the same book. And my consciousness, which was held within its pages, got transferred into his brain. I lived there for a while. Meanwhile, in a parallel dimension, I was evil for a bit. But
was that canon?
That's not important right now.
I fought a vampire.
Steve,
I killed a god or something.
You may know that ever since episode 9. Tom has been collecting body parts.
Oh, yes, I'm aware of this.
Right, and he kept them all in a freezer on the Chum Guzzler.
Didn't someone go back and check to see if that freezer was full?
All right, guys, let's.
I don't know. I wasn't
lost
there.
Season 5 of you right now.
Previously on Drunks and Dragons.
Hey, the island's of this thing. Hey, look, the bird's this.
So Tom went and saw a man whose identity is a mystery. Thrifty, come up with that later. And that man transferred my consciousness into these body parts and sewed them together in a transformation sequence that's very Power Rangers-esque. It looked a lot like a Megazord coming together. That's canon.
Do you guys understand any of this? Oh, sort of.
The smallest bit.
Yeah. And now I live inside that body. He got me out of his head and he got me into these meat parts, which was the only suitable entity for me to possess. And here I am.
The only
suitable entity.
I'm sorry. I didn't study a lot of necromancy magic. I studied a little and... don't yell at me. Because I just imagined the Birdman turtle phase, and I was like, ah! I run and hide behind Jayla's legs.
Listen, Toby, I like you a lot, but I've been living in this body for 5 years, and if somebody were to tell me now that there was a better body for me to live in, that wouldn't go over so well!
I guess, I mean... Well, no, it's not. There's definitely better bodies, but that's okay.
You know, it's not easy being a meat golem. I can't go back to my wife. How would she ever love me the way I look now?
Well,
Steve, Cheryl loves you for you, not because of your body.
Yeah.
Steve,
you haven't returned to Cheryl in all these years.
Yeah.
I'm too afraid. What if she doesn't love me? What if she takes one look at me and she says that I'm hideous? For what woman could ever love a beast?
Maybe she's gone blind in the last 5 years.
Maybe she's dead. A lot of people
die. Oh my god, Toby!
What?
No.
A lot of people die.
Aludra covered his mouth.
Cheryl couldn't be dead. Neither could Aludra, like I almost started to say. Cheryl couldn't be dead.
Now is that a theory?
I did die, but I came back, so it's all right.
I didn't die. I didn't see most of the demon apocalypse, but I was told a lot of people died. Some of my friends are gone, but I'll find them.
This is all too much for me. It's a lot to take in.
Well, do you like your body? I mean, I know a lot of people here, and if you want to...
I mean, you know, my body's okay. It's pretty hideous, and it scares a lot of people, but because of my background, haunted one, those that look into my eyes can see that I've faced unimaginable horror, and that I am no stranger to darkness. Though they might fear me, commoners will extend every courtesy and do their utmost to help me. Unless I have shown myself to be a danger, they will take up arms to fight alongside me should I find myself facing an enemy alone.
I did actually think that one was a little that bit. I was going to talk to you about that bit, but too late now. You already said it on the podcast.
Steve, I'm sure that Cheryl would still love you, and you know what, after we figure out what's going on here, I would be happy to help you find Cheryl again if that's what you want.
I can't let Cheryl see me like this.
Well, I can cast a spell and make you look well. Toby walks up and he touches his frog knee. Like, you know, not all of us are born as good looking as, well, Lord Tyus Harper, or as ugly as a toad, but you know what? If it's in your heart, it's okay. Plus, she's probably dead.
Toby!
Oh!
What?
Toby, I know your heart's in the right place, but you're making me real sad.
What happens when you cry?
Oh, no. It's pus.
Oh.
Out of my eyes.
Aludra again gives the air pat. She cannot quite bring herself to touch
his
owlbear arms.
Steve, what has brought you to the White Spire?
Yes, very good. I'm here. Strange old man. Thank you.
Oh. Well, I don't know if you all know this, but there's been some strange happenings among the White Spire. Yes. Did you all know that there's a city floating above this tower?
We just found that out.
Oddly enough, we found out today.
Wow. Well, I've known for a while now, and I've been investigating it because I think secretly that this city is from another dimension.
It is. And you're right.
Is it? Oh, you found that out for sure. Okay, yeah, good. I'll add that to my notes.
Our fucking traitor friend, he told us all this before he disappeared because it's a city. And
do you think that he was my friend?
Are you asking if Jett was your friend?
Yeah.
Well, considering that he wanted you to be punched by brigands, and he betrayed us.
No.
I don't think he was our friend either.
Wait, oh. Jett Razor? Yeah. Jett Razor was a traitor?
Yeah.
But I love his music. I have all of his CDs. That's I mean, I don't know what to do with them, because I mean, I'd never heard of a CD before. I just got them sitting in a stack on my dresser. But I have them.
Jett Razor's a traitor? I have to tell King Titus Harper.
Oh my god, this is the worst day of my life.
I'm on my way to deliver a note to him right now.
Old Man Weck didn't pop up in the interstitial episode? Oh boy.
You might have.
I didn't listen. I don't know.
Well, Old Man Weck, got some bad news for you. He's dead too.
Wait, did Steve ever meet? Yeah, Steve was. Harper was around when Steve was in. I mean, Harper was around when Steve was in.
I was like, right? Oh, no, Steve lost his mind.
Probably for like 100 episodes.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, listen, Steve's been around so many times, it's hard to keep track.
Yeah,
he's had several different lives.
Yeah.
Wait. King Titus Harper is dead, and also King Titus Harper record scratch.
More pus.
Oh, I'm a queen. I'm a queen now. Also,
what? Now, Aludra, you were always a queen in my eyes.
Oh, Steve. Yeah, she kind of sucks. I kind of ran away. It's all good. It's cool. We're adventuring now, and yep, Titus Harper's dead.
real quick, I just want to address something before we move any further. Steve turns to Jaela. Jaela, why are you so sad?
I guess I'm just, I'm not really sad, Steve. I'm shocked to see you. It's great to see you. Well, I prefer, it's not great to visually look upon your body right now, but I am willing to help you with every fiber of my being.
It's worth noting that Steve, like, I mean, all things considered, is in pretty good shape. He has abs, but none of them are in the place they should be.
They're all like one off, like diagonal abs.
I don't like it.
And you know, I'm just a little upset about the events that just transpired. But
oh yeah, your friend betrayed you. Did you like your friend? Did you think he was a good guy?
I mean, he told dogs to piss on us, so there's that.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't sound like a good guy at all. Would you like us to go kill him, Jaela? Do you want to kill him?
Oh, well, we don't have to kill him.
Steve, do you like killing now?
Oh, you know, I was just kidding.
Steve.
You know, I spent a long time in Tom's brain, and... some things just, you know, they just, you know, when you spend enough time with someone, especially when you live inside the brain,
yeah,
those things just tend to stick, and it's, you know, it's hard to break those habits once they're gone.
Jaela would go up and she would touch Jett. I'm sorry,
take a drink,
Steve.
Whoa.
I don't have any more drink to take. No. That's my problem. She would go up and she would touch his hand and do that where you touch, but then you kind of like pull back, but then she would fight through it and she would grab his hand and she would say, Steve, do you have a darkness within you now?
This is the, it's worth noting, this is the first contact that Steve had with another being that wasn't in combat. Steve's seen a lot of combat in the last
five years.
First time. That Steve has felt the touch of another being. And
what?
And at first he recoils, you know, much in the same way that Jaela does, but he succumbs and he goes, I just miss him so much.
We all miss things about Tom.
I mean, that's real sad, but
shit. Yeah, he's cool, I guess.
Mostly it's Cueca.
But Steve, we're still all here to support each other, and Toby is our newest friend.
I like Toby. He seems great.
Yeah, I'm great.
Toby's so peppy.
He's a good guy.
I don't know how to handle being around all this pep.
Yeah.
But Steve, if you do have this darkness within you, perhaps we should talk later.
It's good to see you again, Jaela.
She'll pat him on his weird back.
Did we ever figure out why you're in my house?
Of course. Yeah, where were we? Above the white spire, there's a beam of energy that's being siphoned from its power.
Oh, yeah, it's
and
like
it's
in
holding
movies.
It's holding up the city, right? You guys said you knew about the city,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And the city is from another dimension.
The Nareevians. When these Nareevians. These dingleberries broke magic a handful of years ago.
Listen. Before I died, I didn't know shit about magic because I was just a simple barbarian. But now that I have access to most of the knowledge of Thokus and Milnor, and 5 years to read books, of course.
I've
learned so much.
Wait, you love magic?
I love magic.
Oh my god, what's your favorite magic?
Oh, my favorite magic is the explodey magic.
Oh, well, I've been reading the collective works of Jalbert, who always thought about maybe... Well,
inside
joke.
I think you mean Yell Bear.
Owl Bear?
Oh yes, sorry. It's one of those words.
It's Jalbert.
Yeah, it's one of those words that you read but you don't say it aloud. Yeah, Yell Bear, the collective works of him and how reality can be bent to your will.
Oh yeah. Yeah, and you can make reality blow itself to shit. It's great.
Yeah, we kinda did that.
Did you make that scary robot?
You mean Jerry?
Yeah.
I have to keep reminding myself his name is Jerry. Yeah, he's great.
I made this.
I assume Jerry's like winding around.
Oh, he's
Steve's legs like a I thought he'd be more like a puppy, like just
if you're unfamiliar with an artificer's construct, the construct cannot speak but can understand any language that I can understand.
Damn.
Which, you know, he can understand, scrolling down, Common, Abyssal, and Gnoll.
Wow.
But he can't talk, mostly because I sewed his mouth shut.
Oh, yeah, you've got to.
Why'd you do that?
Because he was spewing out a bunch of, like, fucking bugbear shit.
Crush him!
You shut your bugbear mouth.
Toby brings out a shitty... what was previously cool, dragon lighter. He's like, I made this. And he holds
wait,
it up
wait,
to
you pull out a what?
One of my little tiny creations. Like, well, I didn't really learn a lot, but you know, being a gnome and all, you kind of pick it up. So here, you can have this. I was saving
for
it
me?
For later. Yeah, it's kind of like Aludra's, but it's not as good. It's a worm who spits fire. It's like a lighter. Here you go.
It's really cool.
That's really neat. I like that a lot. I like the detail to the body.
It's no Jerry, but maybe one.
Well, I mean, there's only one Jerry, but this is great in its own right. You should be proud.
When I was created, artificers weren't a thing, and no shucks.
Oh, you know, you should just be proud that you made it this far.
Yeah, I love it. I love being me. Actually, I have an idea. I can't wait to fall asleep.
that's weird.
An injured man stumbles into the room. Toby recognizes him as Boris.
Boris! Oh my god, you're alive!
Is he invincible? That's a Golden Eye deep cut.
Oh.
Remember that from like the 90s?
Did he previously have a voice? Do we know?
Yeah, he did. It was very great. It was great.
Or Slavic, at least.
I told me.
What? Are you okay? Did you fall in your throat?
What is happening, Toby?
I think I would remember that. I don't know. But I'm rolling with these. Remember when I told you about Harper dying? And then I ran away. Well, I busted out that witch. And then I met up with Aludra and Jaela.
I have tidings of grave news.
What? Did you bring my stuff from our room? How's our room?
It is mostly undestroyed at this point. But I was in the chamber with Cornelius.
Talionis? He's gonna be so mad. Did he mention me?
I think something is amiss. Uh-oh. He seemed to go all puddly for a minute.
Puddly.
I must.
He's a Nareevian?
I'm just going to drop that piece of that little plot hook, and then I'm going to go because I'm very scared this whole place is going to come down.
Oh, well, thank you for bringing my new spell book. Thanks. Toss it here, bud.
I couldn't find it.
Fuck you!
This one's empty. Huh? You can use it as a journal if you like.
Oh, Steve goes, isn't it weird that this room has four walls and one of them's broken?
There's more rubble than there was walls before, but yet my room is still up. Okay, you said he gave me a journal?
Yeah. I love that. He gave you a journal.
Oh, what's his journal? I open it.
It's a blank journal.
It's for you to fill with adventures.
It's got a nice pen that you could just write in.
Fuck, that's not how it works. I have a spell book. You agreed. We said it.
What? No, you said you couldn't find a spell book. He brought you a journal.
No. Well, you also said my room was mostly intact, so deuses.
Your diary.
Well, on that very exciting note,
you're living on a journal hook?
I feel like we should. That's everyone's going to be like, no, a journal. Oh my god, what's going to happen in episode 202?
Wait, are you ending it right now? I feel like the episode hasn't even started yet, but I may be
going
wrong.
For an hour and 2 minutes.
RPing so fucking hard, and Michael is just sitting back like, when are they going to shut up and let me talk?
No, that's his favorite
part. I had to bring in a whole extra NPC just so I could say something.
Michael, though.
Yeah, Tim.
I'm going to get that spell book, okay?
I know you want it bad.
But, I gave you the... Actually, I'm going to get the spell book. I've decided. Thank you.
Wow.
It's one. It was said. And maybe we'll talk about it off air. And...
I think that's a really good idea.
Yeah.
But we have a lot of feedback. Do you want to read some of that?
Oh, that's good. Actually, I'll read some feedback if I can have a spell book. You see, amazing, says, what have I done from the United States?
This is not a high energy.
This is the new greatest show on earth. This has become a great part of my life and finally got cut up.
Fine, you can have a spell book.
This special ever. Outcast 68 from the United States has better life than ever. Not really. So I started playing D&D a little over a year ago and wanted to find a podcast that I could listen to and learn from, and found it. Spoilers. Tom died. Moment of silence for the darksicle. And then Tom, seven, and Harper overcomes his dark past by exploding, all of which I saw on the wiki because I looked before I caught up. And spoilers. Thank you so much for your review. Lemon Poot from the United States says, fly slurish. Good Dame 8. I can't stand listening to podcasts in general, but I made it all the way through chapter 1, about 150 episodes, and you guys certainly helped me delay my inevitable decline into cynicism at work. I give you 5 stars because it is likely the only podcast I'll ever gone through with such purity. I think Bachmann is a distant cousin or something, because I have obscure thoughts that he regularly vocalized shortly after. I have nothing but love for Tim and Jennifer. Wonderful chemistry. I was very happy when Nika was added to the show, and she does a wonderful job of not letting her gaming experience get in the way of her shining personality. Not sure what that means. And a voice! DiMauro, I play a strict demon, but with these silverweed smoking drunks, you have what patience and guidance is required to actually keep it together as a real game podcast. Cheers. Good for Lonely Nights from the artist formerly known as Pins. It's the president. The new president. If struck working long graves like me, I recommend this podcast. It's truly hilarious. Though it does come with the risk of having temporary retreat from the sale floor because you've teared up from laughter and ruined your mascara. Lunatar says, everyone on board the Tinker Train. I'm a slabber and still love the show. Awesome show and everyone, and keep up the good work. Jett Arnold says, rocks out with the cloaca. Very entertaining, even if you never leave the bedroom. Wink. I was with the show for 195 episodes until Michael said he didn't even like Harry Potter. In all seriousness, I love this podcast. I just caught up in time for episode 200. Holy fuck.
You guys know I have a Harry Potter podcast, right?
Like, that's hilarious.
Yeah, but no, yeah. Congrats to you all, and take a shot for episode 200. Worth it, and he knows you're Harry Potter. This is too much feedback. Worth it. Joe Loke.
Oh, there's 20 pages of it.
United States. I've been listening since Dark Blades. I love you. Bo Narrates from USA. Please stop. A couple months ago, I started listening to Drunks and Dragons. Since then, my life has gone downhill. It started out with a little stuff from stealing drunk guys' coats at bars. Or when asked who my favorite celebrity couple is, I replied, Tim and Jennifer Cheek. He says many more nice things. Or she. Thank you very much. Steal your girl. Hashtag 777. Much podcast. Such good. I'm only on in episode 116 at the moment, but you guys won't stop pestering me for a 5-star review. So here it is. Right. Everyone on the podcast is amazing. I can't get over how great an addition Nika-chan it was the podcast. You guys are awesome. Please never stop doing what you're doing. Grime, the undercover from South Africa. Awesome what? Podcast. I've been listening to this podcast since November 2016 and only gotten to episode 85 or so. Always used to think that D&D was a very nerdy game, but have come to appreciate it after listening to you guys battle over the past few months. McGee and me from Sivo PSN from Canada. G'day mate, reference after reference, each gag and goof edges me closer to climax. Totally boy horny for Drunks and Dragons. Best group I've ever heard from Grim Wilder. You guys are what get me through my graveyard shift at work. Love you guys, you are the best. Made me like podcast by Yo Mix from Canada. G'day mates, been listening for a while and unfortunately I'm catching up. This podcast makes all my Mondays chores a lot better. Lost count of how many times people have looked at me weird because I keep laughing a lot of punk dead RP bananas. Great stuff. By Whose Holds Shiny Rounds. This was the first podcast I listened to for more than an episode. Now I've been lurking for over a year and just caught up to episode 198. Very disappointed I don't have anything to binge listen to anymore. Listening since November, first time reviewer since Diomede Exulans. I'm about to start episode 100 and I'm so excited for this. Y'all are by far the best D&D podcast I've ever listened to. The chemistry between everyone is amazing, and even adding Nika as Jaela wasn't a hard transition at all. I still hold a place in my heart for Tum Tum. Binging and can't stop. Luludinir 1016 says, I've been listening for 20 days and I'm about to start episode 100. I can't wait to catch up. You guys, gals, rock. Love the group and all your awkward, hilarious goofs. Makes my life complete from Krista Barrett. Recently started listening and I fell in love. You keep me awake during the long, boring hours at work. You guys are amazing, and I can't wait to be part of the community. Fly Slurish, again, by Princess Avi the First. I hijacked my daughter's phone just so I could have leave you another 5 stars. Now that is the thing to do.
You there are you truly a hero.
Fair podcast, 7777 out of 5 stars from Maturicus. It took me about months, but I'm finally caught up. Sorry to be that guy and wait to review. Now that I'm waiting for the week-to-week between episodes, I figured what better way to spend my time. The podcast is gold. A great resource for new DM by Golf for Miami. Golf for Miami. This podcast has been a great escape from the problems of the world as of late. Been binge listening at the insistence of a friend and almost caught up. As a newer DM, this podcast has been a huge help in many ways. Thank you.
That's such a great feedbacks.
Yeah.
Those are so good.
Oh, we're stopping?
There's a lot of them. I think we should because it's
a lot.
Another 8 hours? All right.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us. If you want to get in touch with us, we're on Twitter at GeeklyInc or at D&D Podcast. I'm at Thrifty Nerd.
I'm at Tim Lanning.
I'm at Jennifer Sheik.
I'm at Nika_Howard.
I'm at the Mike Bachmann.
didn't get your fill of action and adventure in this episode of Drunks and Dragons? Well, you can check out these other Geekly Inc. shows, including Brute Force, Cast of Thrones, Cthulhu and Friends, The Host Westworld, Pope Zone, Transformation Sequence, and Your Wizardary. Yeah. You can also visit us at geeklyinc.com, where you can read the always updating content and check out some fan art by the talented community artists. Afterwards, make sure to head over to the shop and okay, buy some merchandise for your next adventuring quest. After you've gotten over Steve and Old Man Weck being back, head on over to iTunes to leave us a 5-star rating and review. Want to do another listen through? Check out the D&D podcast abridged episodes available for download now. All the fun in a tenth of the time. Also, don't forget to head over to patreon.com/dndpodcast, where you can donate a monthly amount to help us make this podcast better with each episode. GeeklyCon 2017 tickets are on sale now. It's going to be held in St. Louis, Missouri, and you can get your ticket as well as your hotel room online. Information is also available on the forums for ride or room shares, so grab your ticket and get ready for the fun. New episodes come out every Monday, so go subscribe, get your quest log filled, and get ready for things to get dicey.
Yay! Thank you, everybody. We will be back next week. Until then, keep it dicey.
Yeah.
Stop an export?
Stop an export.
Let's do it.
Dang it. My thing is like...
Sorry, Tim. I didn't mean to cut you off. I just...
Never do it again.
It just... we have so much.
No. No worries. Bud. This is, 201.
Yes, it is.
What a fun thing to say, Utlud.
Wait till we say 301.
Oh, wait till we say 69.
Oh, 20!
Oh, oh, oh God, boy.
That's a long time from now.
Aludra, Jennifer is your real name. I just put a link in the Drunks and Dragons chat, and I'm going to need you to explain it to me.
Okay, I'm really excited to see what it is right now.
Yeah, I remember that.
I don't remember that or what it is referencing.
Are they licking it?
Boy, yeah. I don't remember that either. But, you know, it's been a wild ride, so who can say?
I was like, where did you guys get a megaphone? Oh, that's your hammer.
That's some weird, there's some weird shit going on there. And who's dead in the background?
I don't know.
It might be Tum?
I don't remember nearly anything.
I checked the comments, and they don't... Oh, they say in the background there's Bucky, Daisy, and Uncle Harper?
Oh, Harper's alive there.
Yes.
In three years ago? Really?
God. We've been doing this podcast forever.
Yeah.
Harper has been around for a long time. Too long.
Oldest character,
which is why he had to go.
Yeah, Harper's the oldest character.
Oldest character, that's true.
The longest lasting character. I'm going to be right back.
Yeah, I'm going
to
go.
I have to change my diaper.
Wait, Tim, are you in a diaper? Tim Lanning in a diaper. Is that you?
What? Oh. Oh! That's funny. Stream. I'm going to shut the stream down for just a second to save my hard drive space. But we are recording another episode, so we'll be back in just one moment.